Hi, I'm Dr. D, professor here in AeroAstro. Welcome to my office hours.
How's it going?
Good.
How did you get interested in both space and aeronautics?
Well, perhaps like many people of my age, it all starts with Star Trek. As a young boy, I was hooked on Star Trek reruns of the original series. I know there are a lot of opinions on which Star Trek genre is the most important, but something about just that whole episode, and then of course the onset of other science fiction movies, especially after that, really got me hooked. And so when I was seemingly attracted to engineering for my college degree, aerospace was my choice, and the rest has been history. All three of my degrees are in aerospace, and I love it.
We know you do a lot at work, but what do you do outside of work or academia?
I work with primarily with two emerging students, i.e. my kids, who are 10 years old and 3.5 years old. But as much as I'd like to elaborate, you know, really with two kids, it is when I'm not working, and of course part of my work does require a lot of travel, which is a bit hard on the family as well. So when I'm not working and I'm not traveling for work, I really do enjoy spending just as much time as possible with my kids, playing baseball or and other things. And I do find a time to read. I like to read actually a mix of what I call science fiction, but also kind of near term, you know, this convergence of you know, artificial intelligence and the future of humanity and those kinds of things. So I think my research, which is on systems, a very broad topic, also influences my reading.
Here's a scenario. It's your last day on Earth, assuming you're going to Mars, of course. What are you going to do?
Oh, gosh. Well, thanks for that positive spin that I'm going somewhere. I am hopping in the car or the urban air mobility airplane or whatever is available with my wife and my two kids, who may at that point have kids themselves. And we are going to the best available, reachable Italian restaurant and having some homemade, hopefully homemade quality ravioli with meatballs and a couple glasses of wine. To me, that sounds like a great send-off.
What's a fun fact students should know about you?
Students should know that I like to tell stories. And one reason they should know that is because when they ask for my advice, since I'm a person just like them that's gone through any stage that they're going through, whether it's an undergraduate student or a graduate student, or even we get visits from high school students thinking about college, you know, I've been through those steps and I usually have an interesting story that I reflect on that I really learn from. And so they better be prepared for some good stories.
What's your favorite part about being a professor?
My favorite part of being a professor is being a part of things like this, which is seeing every, you know, new student come into my class or into my research program. This happens to be one of my PhD students who decided to stay as a research staff member here. But seeing people accomplish amazing things, including standing on the proverbial stage and receiving their degree, it's just sort of a way to just propagate good things to good people. And I really love that part of it.
What motivates you?
What motivates me is the desire to continually test my boundaries of how big of the systems problem that I can define and tackle together with my students and my colleagues. But there's a larger system that the airplane has to work in, and that's called the air transportation system. And then there's a larger societal question of, you know, how we maximize societal good across everyone, and that's more than just transportation. That's energy, that's quality of life. So it gets me in trouble sometime, but I really like to think, what is the biggest problem we can tackle and make the most good?
Well, thank you so much for your time. It was great to get to know you a bit more.
Sure. Thank you.